climate and the Walking Dead, and it's nice to be actually part of a solution, which it's nice to create art that actually heals and causes families to take a look at themselves and be grateful for what they have, and communities to do the same. So that is a big part of why I'm interested in this project, and I'm really excited about what the writers have done with Carson and giving me the opportunity to be a part of this and be in this incredible little family. So really grateful. Thank you.
So, some of you may recognize the actor sitting next to Paul. His name is Bradford Boyd.
Wraps up filming this week. You guys are here for the final
guys are here while it's happening. There's 44 hours after this season four finale, so we still got like, what, 56 to go?
Oh yeah, we got. We got years.
Want to call your attention to get to that runner is Michael Shepherd. Michael, stand up. Michael. Michael is the first to take care of the show in Canada. And we've been very blessed and very fortunate that the Canadian broadcasters, because of all of you, have taken the liking to the show. And for us to continue for the 10 seasons, it has only happened because of what Michael's done in Canada. And we're all very grateful, Michael. Thank you.
Okay, let's get back to our cast. Lori, we have another question for you from Sherry Handfinger from Chapel Hill, North Carolina. And she's asking, do you cook in real life as well as you do in Abigail's?
My husband thinks I do. But I think Abigail is a far better baker than I am. And I'm like the one pan cook. Like, I don't like a lot of cleanup, but if I can make it in one pot or one pan, that's my recipe. That's my go-to. So I would say Abigail is much better than I am. However, Rebecca Donaldson was a terrible cook, and I'm a little bit better than she is.
Very good. Well, I know they're all gonna see if there's any leftovers at Abigail's tomorrow morning.
By the way, don't eat anything in the mercantile. It's been there for 4 years. Do not eat it. Paul Green said to Aaron and I the other day, hey, how much would you guys give me if I ate one of those pickled eggs? I'm like, no, you'll die. Don't do it.
Okay, Carter, we're going to talk to you again here for a second, buddy. This is a question from me, actually. Wow. So I hear it's kind of hard to find shows to audition for, movies to audition for, that sort of match what your family cares about, right? So, you know, is When Calls a Heart a good match for what your family cares about and what you care about?
Yes, it is. But my mom and dad, when they were teaching my sister and I things, they teach us to be respectful and thoughtful to other people. Be honest, be a good listener, even when it might be hard for me a lot, too. be respectful, I think I already said that. And also be grateful for what we have, because there's a lot of people who are less fortunate. And my second home is Hope Valley, and I love it.
Aww. Oh, my goodness!
Good.
Sweet Carter. No.
He's a boy. He's still a boy. He would like to blow things up or maybe set the fire somewhere or something. Thanks, Carter. Okay, so Aaron, this
yes.
question comes from you, from Bobby Whitlock in Choctaw, Oklahoma. Okay. And
all right, Oklahoma.
She's asking, yeah, Oklahoma. There you go. So she's asking, what has been your favorite scene to shoot so far, but also the most challenging scene in your, I guess,
try to avoid this question. I don't know if you've noticed that. Oh, they're all my favorites. Oh, they're all challenging. They are, but I would say, without a doubt, my favorite scene and the most challenging scene, they've both definitely come from season four. So you haven't seen them yet. I know, and it's true. It's true. I'll give you an answer, but that's the honest truth. So you'll see them, and you'll know what I mean. Hopefully. But I would say the most challenging scene for me, probably emotionally, they're both for you actually, was the end of season three. Oh, I know. Spoiler alert, I'm sure you've all seen it. But Jack was in trouble and was laid up in bed, and it was very emotional. We didn't know if he was going to survive. And
that was a really good, that was a
guys that.
Seriously, I actually fell asleep.
I'm like, you know, acting my heart out, just crying over him as like. So that was probably the most challenging. And then my favorite scene, I think, was the end of season one. We waited all season.